Extracting Cloud EPM Planning data to a flat file allows you to load the exported data file to another cloud system, as journals into a third-party ERP system to include in a data warehouse for consolidated reporting and analysis across several systems, or simply as a data file backup. To extract data from planning using data integration, begin by navigating to Data Exchange. By default, Cloud EPM creates two applications for you, File and EPM Local, which points to your current application. I'll register a data export to file type application and associate a data load template. The data load template must contain a header row that lists the dimensions that will be included in the output file. I'll make sure that the application dimensions are mapped correctly to the data table column name in the data integration staging tables. In Options, select a workflow mode. Simple workflow mode bypasses the workbench and loads data directly to the target. Full No Archive and Full Workflow mode processes and loads data to the staging tables. The difference is that for Full No Archive, data is cleared from the staging tables if the export is successful. I'm selecting Full to make sure data can be viewed in the workbench. Full workflow mode is also ideal for small data volume extracts. Use period mappings to match period formats between the source and target system. You can use various kinds of calendars with period granularity based on your business and application requirements. I need mappings for months in FY24. Define category mappings to map planning scenarios in your source and target. I'll define an integration and go through the workflow tasks starting with general details. A name and location are required for the integration. Quick mode offers significant performance benefits by providing faster processing compared to the standard workflow method when extracting large data volumes. For example, when extracting a large volume of only level 0 members. Quick mode supports transformations using import expressions. Data is not staged and cannot be viewed in the workbench. Select the source application in Cube. Then select the target and a category or scenario. In this case, I'll be extracting data from my EPM local application to the data export to file application I registered. Source and target selections are saved to a location. You can reuse locations in other integrations. I'll set the functional currency of the location to USD. Next, map source dimensions to target dimensions. Mappings are saved to an import format. I'll apply the copy source target expression to copy the source value to the target. Because I've selected to copy source values between dimensions, I won't need to map members. In the last workflow task, you specify filters and integration options. I'll set filter conditions so that I can extract unit account data for all products in the Sales East entity. In Options, I'll verify that the category is set to plan, matching the scenario I specified in General Details of the Filter tab. I'll also make sure that the source cube is set to Plan 1. For Data Extract option, I'll be exporting stored data only. Select the delimiter for the output file. I'll review the rest of the integration options, then save and close the integration. Before running the integration, I'll open a form that displays the data I want to export. Here's the data I expect to be included in the output file. I'll return to Data Exchange and run the integration. Setting the import mode to replace clears all the data for the data point of view in the workbench. I'll set the start and end period, then run the integration. The integration execution status message displays the progress of the integration. When the integration completes successfully, I'll go to the workbench to look at the data in the staging tables. Here's the data extracted from planning. Next, I'll review process details and download the output file. The extracted data file contents are displayed. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.